MMA Rants and Raves, UFC 223, Khabib Nurmagomedov versus Max Holloway for the UFC Lightweight Championship of the World. Guys, let's talk about this fight. Well, guys, I guess if there is a fight that is never destined to happen, it's Tony and Khabib. I mean, come on, I think this fight was scheduled to happen back in 2016. One guy can't make it, then the other guy can't make it. One guy can't make weight, the other guy gets hurt. I mean, it's always something that happens to prevent this fight from happening. And it happened in such short notice, about a week away, and now the fight is off. But guess who steps up? One of the most indestructible forces the UFC has ever seen, and a guy named Max Holloway. I mean, I'm telling you guys, I've watched this guy fight. I don't even remember him bleeding in a fight. I mean, he is so incredibly tough. He just puts himself in such danger, and he just continues to succeed. This guy is just incredible. I mean, his toughness, people talk about his technique and his footwork, his speed, his cardio, but it's really toughness. I mean, he's been hit real hard. One of his strategies is just have the other guy wear himself out, but you still have to take punishment, and, you know, he's taken a ton of punishment. I mean, two fights against Jose Aldo. He fought Conor McGregor. I mean, he has been through so many tough fights, and he's barely scratching the surface. I mean, he's a young guy. He's about 26. It's really incredible all that he's done. And now you have a guy like Khabib. He seems to have been around forever. I mean, the guy is 25-0. He's fought a lot of fights, and he hasn't even fought for a title yet. So it just shows how quick Holloway has risen through the ranks. Of course, the lightweight division, I think, is the deepest as far as a roster of fighters, so I think you have to do a lot more to get to that title shot. Featherweight was one of the newer weight classes to come in, especially when the WEC guys spilled into the UFC. But even so, it's still a very good division, a very tough division. But, you know, I was kind of thinking, I don't know if you guys thought about this, out of all of Holloway's most notable victories, he's faced guys that strike. Guys that are known to stand and strike. I can't remember him facing a very tough wrestler. I mean, the only time I've seen him get out-wrestled was by Conor McGregor. However, now, he's not only facing just a wrestler. He may be facing, pound for pound, the greatest wrestler that the UFC has ever seen. Now, I can't give him that description yet because he doesn't have that strap around his waist. But when they do pound for pound rankings, you know, they can also do pound for pound wrestlers and pound-for-pound strikers, and I'm telling you, this guy may be that guy. I mean, his wrestling is so off the charts good. Just look at the things that he's done in the lightweight division already. I mean, it's pretty incredible how high level he is. So he's going from one extreme, not having faced really good wrestlers, to maybe a guy who is the greatest wrestler that the UFC has ever seen. It really is hard to say right now. He has to, of course, win the championship. If you put people in the category of great. But it's just, you know, really interesting to see the progress that this guy has done. Now, Holloway and Ferguson do have things in common. They're tall, lanky guys. They're rangy for their weight classes. They're extremely tough, both of them. I mean, they've been hit real hard, just really good chins. They both have world-class cardio, so they do have that in common. However, Tony is more well-rounded. I mean, Tony's chokes are nasty, real slick. He throws nasty upkicks. I remember him knocking out a guy with an upkick. I think that's how he won the Ultimate Fighter. So he is so dangerous on the ground. Now, as far as Holloway, I really haven't seen his groundwork. Now, credit to him, he's been so darn good. We really haven't had the need to see it. I mean, he's so good on his feet. However, the question is, which everybody's asking, is how in the world is he going to stop Khabib's takedowns? And keep in mind, you know, people are saying, well, Holloway has a clear advantage standing up. I'm telling you, Khabib's stand-up is underrated, and I think that's because his wrestling is so good. I mean, I remember when he fought Edson Barboza, who's a very high-level striker. I mean, he hit Barboza with some good shots. When he was coming in, he was aggressive, and he landed some strikes. So he could possibly clock Holloway with something, and maybe that would enable him to get his takedowns, because he's going to have to do that. I don't think he could just be a cut-and-dry wrestler against Holloway. Holloway's too experienced, despite his age, but if you look at all his experience fighting, I mean, he knows it's coming. So Khabib is going to have to mix it up. And as far as Khabib is concerned, I really haven't even seen him face adversity. I mean, that's how dominant he's been. The only time I've seen, well, maybe there was a chink in his armor is when he fought Michael Johnson, where he looked like he was rocked. So that's actually a sign that this is a guy that can overcome adversity. He came back and it was one of the most dominant performances that he's had, despite being hit early. Holloway, of course, has a loss on his record, but Khabib has been so dominant. And of course, Holloway is stepping up a weight class. The question is, what kind of Holloway are we going to see? Now, granted, he's big for a featherweight, but moving up to lightweight, I mean, will we see a slower Holloway? Will we see a stronger Holloway? Holloway's known for his volume more than his power. Will we see more power from Holloway? So it's kind of going to be interesting. I mean, it is a different weight class. It's going to be interesting to see what he looks like coming into that fight. Like I said, he is big for a featherweight. But keep in mind that size and range has helped him. He uses it very well in his fights. Now, he's not going to have that as much. Khabib is a monster lightweight. I mean, really big. So the question is, how will that work? And of course, he's facing a wrestler. If he couldn't stop takedowns at featherweight, how will he do it at lightweight? And I can't believe I'm calling Khabib a lightweight. I mean, that guy is super big. I think he'd make a really good welterweight. Just a really big guy. And he just looked outstanding against Barboza. I mean, I can imagine Barboza versus Holloway would be like a war because of the way those guys fight. But against Khabib, it was just, I mean, a real dominant performance. Now, of course, what's going to benefit Holloway is the fact that it's a five-round fight. We know Holloway's not getting tired, and we know how tough he is, so it's likely he's going to be able to take some of Khabib's strikes. The question is, I just don't know about the wrestling. He's just got to keep Khabib at bay, you know, use his jabs, his range, his striking, and try to wear Khabib out. I mean, if the Tony and Khabib fight was intriguing, I think this fight may be even more intriguing because it's a question mark fight. It's basically Khabib versus a question mark. I don't know how Holloway's going through. Here's another point I want to bring up. I can't remember a time where there was a title fight and one guy got hurt and then someone stepped up in about a week's notice and has won. So, I mean, that's also interesting. You know, how is that going to affect him? You know, changing things around. Holloway, of course, is going to be in a different weight class. He has a very short time to prepare for a guy like this. And, of course, this is Khabib's backyard. I mean, he's been fighting here a long time, so he's coming into his domain. Now, the pressure is more on Khabib than it is Holloway. I mean, Holloway already is a champion. So, you know, if he doesn't come out victorious in this fight, people can say, well, look, he stepped up a weight class. This is not his division. So it may be more expected. With Khabib, there's more pressure. So the pressure factor may be on him. It's going to be really interesting to see how Holloway's takedown defense has progressed and to see how Khabib's weight cut goes, how his cardio goes, and how much time he can control. Because, you see, I compare ground game and striking to like football. You know, stand up is like passing the ball because the offense really can build up quickly and a knockout blow can happen where the rest of the game could be garbage time. But the ground game, what that does is it eats clock. And in MMA, you have a very short clock. It's 25 minutes, much shorter than a football game. And on the ground, when you have top position, that clock can go by very quickly. So Khabib easily could be up several rounds and he can kind of coast. So that can be interesting. Holloway's strategy in the past, especially against Aldo, was allow the opponent to build up offense, get some points early, and then take over the fight because he has that cardio. So it's going to be interesting to see what his strategy is. This is like a classic striker versus grappler type of match. It really is. I'm going to go with momentum. Striker versus grappler. I usually think the odds are with the grappler, especially a grappler on the level of a fighter that Khabib is. So I'm going to go to prediction here. I have Khabib Nurmagomedov to win this fight. I would like to know what you think about the fight. Please leave your comments. Please subscribe. Please like up this video. And thank you for tuning in.